What's going on, guys? Steve and Susanna, and today we are at Disney Springs at a new restaurant that just opened recently, Jaleo, by Chef Jose Andre. It's an authentic Spanish cuisine. They've got paellas, a whole menu of different types of tapas. Looks really, really interesting. We were checking it out online. We both got hungry. We said, you know what? Let's go try Jaleo. So guess what? You guys are coming along with us. Y'all are going to check it out with us. So we're getting ready to head inside. We're going to take a look at the menu, and I think we're going to get to eat because I'm hungry.
Yeah, I'm hungry too.
And I wanted to also say thank you to all of the new subscribers out there. We really appreciate your support. It helps the channel a lot. And if you're new to the channel, now's a great time to hit the subscribe button and also click the little bell notification icon. That way you can be alerted anytime we upload new videos. All right, guys, we're heading inside. Come on with us. All right, well, we're inside Jaleo. Wow, it is a gorgeous, gorgeous restaurant. Got one bar off here to the side. Really pretty modern dining area. Looks really, really cool. Now, when we were seated, our server said on this side is where... Saffron, yeah. On this side is where they prepare all of the paella. And actually, if you look down in there, you should be able to see it. Check that out. Yes. Looks really good. All of the wines. I believe now on this side is where they're preparing all of the tapas. Now we're in here for a late lunch, but we're having dinner. And it's wide open, it's quiet. So I don't know if you can actually get over here maybe a little bit earlier, just before dinner. Check this out, you almost have this place to yourself. But yeah, so this is where it looks like they're preparing all of the salads and the tapas and everything. And I can tell you guys, it smells so good. I'm so hungry. I'm so hungry. All the cheeses back here. The hams, jamon. Looks really, really cool. All right, well, I'm gonna head over here to the tables. I'm gonna show you guys what I ordered. And we didn't go too crazy. We just wanted to kind of, you know, we definitely wanted to get a paella. So, I mean, if you're coming to a place like this, you want paella. And I want to show you guys, too. This is the water view. If you want to sit outside, check out the view you have. It's so cool. Gorgeous view from outside. Really, really cool view if you want to sit outside. All right, so menu-wise, it's a pretty complex menu, but it's tapas style. Now, for myself personally, I will admit, something that I don't have a lot of experience with is paella. And where I grew up, paella is not that common. I think it's probably in a lot of American cities, you'll have a hard time finding a really good paella, seafood paella, or some type of meat paella. One day in the future, when I go to Spain, I'll have a real paella to compare it to. But anyway, so from what I understand, though, the paella here is supposed to be really authentic. Let's see, where do we want to start? It's a little bit tricky for me, just trying to like decipher the Espanol to Inglés. Pan de cristal con tomato. So these are like toasted, you can read it there, toasted slices of uniquely crispy and ethereal bread brushed with fresh tomato, which sounds really good. These are kind of like your appetizers. Ah, here we go. This is the chicken paella. Cool. Check that out. Doesn't that look good? Okay, great. Thank you so much. Yeah. All right. Well, that was quick. That came out very quick. Our server did say that the paella was pretty much ready. So here's a list of quesos, all the different types of quesos that you can get. Anyway, back to this side, though. The bien provicio. These are kind of like your appetizers. You can read what those are. I'll let you just kind of read those yourselves. But then here are the quesos. And they actually have a deal. You can select three for $19, or five for $28. And those are the different types of quesos that you can get. This one was interesting, and my wife being Armenian, I know she's all about this one. Maybe next time we come back, we'll do it. It's the Jose's Taco, which is a caviar taco. I mean, in, you know, maybe not in the United States, we're not huge caviar fans, but a lot of, in Europe, caviar is huge. So they have caviar tacos. The head on the shrimp. Well, this is head on shrimp with garlic, olive oil. Jose doesn't, I don't exactly know how that's set up. I'll have to ask the waiter about that one. Anyways, keep on coming down. Enchiladas, different types of salads. Let's flip the page here. But we did get an order of the croquettes. And what else did we get? Ah, here they are. Oh, okay. Cool. Oh, yeah, I like that. Check that out. Come served on a pillow. That's really cool. Awesome.
Thank you.
Now, we did get the patates bravas. I'm waiting for that. So we have everything on the table now, except for... No, this is the... These are the chicken croquettes. So we're waiting on the patates, which is fried potatoes and a spicy tomato sauce with aioli. And aioli, I'm sorry. So I'll let you guys kind of just read this menu for yourself because it's a lot on here. Coming on around, you do have some plates for two. You can see those. And of course, we went the paella route, and today we got the chicken shrimp paella, which is on the table. So I think we're going to dig into that while it's nice and hot. We're going to start on the croquettes, and we'll start on the paella. So let's do it. Okay, let's enjoy while it's nice and hot. All right. So I'm going to try it. I'm going to try the croquette first. This guy, off the little pillow. Yeah. All right, let's see how the croquette
is.
This is chicken. Chicken croquette. Mmm. Oh, it's very good. The cheese, it's crispy. Nice and hot. Not, yeah, it's good, right? You like it?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
I've had croquettes before.
This is first time I'm eating.
Well, didn't we have croquettes in Miami when we went to the Cuban restaurant?
In Hawaii.
Thank you, buddy. Appreciate
so
that.
Much.
I feel like we did.
Mm-hmm.
But those were ham, I feel like.
Mm. They're hot.
It's very good, though. Croquette is awesome. I like that.
Ah,
the patates is good.
Garlic aioli and parsley puree on the top of that already.
Awesome. That
Thanks
was
so
really
much.
Good.
Tastes even better. Yes. So how I recommend it, you get a couple bites of it first without the sauce on it, get a little bit of flavor, and after, mix all the flavors up and just mix everything and enjoy it.
Excellent.
Lots
Thank of flavor.
You so much.
Everything was really, really good. Thank you, buddy. All right, so the patates bravas is here. Let's dig in on that one. All right, let's see this. I'm gonna move our little pillow to the side, move the paella, which I haven't tried yet. Let's do the patates next, the potatoes. All right, now the patates bravas again, that was fried potatoes with spicy tomato sauce and an aioli. Get the little spicy tomato sauce. Next in. It's really good. It's not overly spicy. Tomato sauce is good. It's really good. You want to try yours yet?
Yeah, of course.
Here, taste it. You like that? Very good. Mm-hmm. All right, and let me do the little tasting of this paella. Rice. The mushrooms. Alright. This is the chicken and mushrooms paella. Famous paella. Mmm. Mm-hmm.
Is it fried?
I think it's fried a little bit. You know, when they do the paella in the big paella pan, so. Mm-hmm. That's good. You want to try yours? Okay. All right, well, let's eat a little bit, get a little bit more of the taste in, and we'll get back to you guys. I tell you, I'm really enjoying the paella.
Yeah.
The chicken is really good. The mushrooms are awesome. The rice tastes great. Very good.
They have special seasoning.
Yeah.
Because it has a special taste that I never tried. I guess this is the Spanish seasoning inside.
Well, I told when I went back up there that they have that they're using saffron. Mm-hmm. So maybe that's a saffron taste too. The spice.
They use saffron too.
Yeah, Armenian food has a lot of saffron in it, especially our rice pilafs and stuff. We use a lot of that. It's very good. And I'm enjoying the patates, the potatoes with the aioli sauce and the tomato sauce. These may be, I mean, not that anything's the best yet, but I really, really, really like these. And I was kind of just like, eh, let's get some potatoes to mix in with our tapas. This is good. Tastes very good. Alright. Can I have another croquette?
Yeah, of course. The pila and paella starting with P, I guess it's the same. It's like a pila.
Yeah, that's a good question. I never thought about that. It's pilaf and paella. It's Espanol for pilaf. It's Spanish for pilaf, maybe. You know what, guys? If y'all know the answer to that, let me know in the comments. Or let us know in the comments down below. But I mean, that's a quick Google question. What does paella translate to in English or something? Or is paella the same thing as pilaf? Croquettes are good. And I do remember, we had croquettes one time in Miami, a Cuban restaurant. But those are ham croquettes. This is the chicken, which is, it's really good. Presentation is nice. I tell you what, if you're out here at Disney Springs, I think you guys would enjoy Jaleo, right? I mean, the menu is so big. There's so many tapas selections on that menu. I'm sorry I can't pronounce half of them. But
next time.
Yeah, well, next time we come, we'll have to just try some more. But
something else.
Yeah, but when people come out here, there's so much for them to pick from. You know, everyone should be able to find something on their menu that they'll like. So let's keep on eating. All right, well, for dessert, we decided to move outside. We wanted to let you guys see this gorgeous view of the lake behind us, Saratoga Springs, directly across the water out that way. So let me show you guys the dessert menu and what we ended up actually getting. Okay, desserts. Pastries, I guess it's, I say pastries, but let's take a look. So the olive oil ice cream with grapefruit sounded really, really good. The way the waiter described it is like it's ice cream that's prepared with olive oil, and the grapefruit is almost, it's like, how do I describe it? Like lemon zest, like zesting of the grapefruit onto the ice cream. And they have traditional flan. What was this? The chocolate custard bread. The chocolate custard bread, we didn't have that one explained to us, but you can kind of read that for yourselves. We ended up, though, getting, or myself, no, who got the cheesecake? You did. Susanna, she got the Basque region of Spain, Basque. The Basque-style cheesecake made with goat cheese and a seasonal sorbet. He said that we're about to try these, by the way. We haven't actually had them yet. I just wanted to show you guys the menu real quick before the desserts come out. But anyway, he said that the seasonal sorbet is a way to kind of sweeten up the tartness of the goat cheese. Again, being Armenian, we eat a lot of, you know, feta cheeses and goat cheeses, so for us it might not be tarts. I think we're going to enjoy that one. And then for myself, I got the house made ice cream, all three flavors. So they're on the way out. Here's the dessert wines if you wanted to go that route, and dessert spirits. All right, we're just waiting for our desserts. All right, let's see what we got here. Our desserts have arrived. And they look very good, very interesting. So this is the goat cheese cheesecake. This is the strawberry sorbet. This is my ice cream, it's a strawberry sorbet. This one is cherry, correct? Yeah, cherry sorbet. This is orange, and this is like the cinnamon cracker. Cinnamon like biscotti that comes with it. I'm not saying that right. All right, which one should I try first? I try your cheesecake first? All right, let's get the cheesecake. I'm gonna just try it by itself so I can just see what the goat cheese tastes like. It is good, it's sweet. Like this is what I was saying again, is for us, because we're used to eating more like feta cheeses and stuff, I don't overly taste like a tart flavor. It's sweet. So if I take a little bit of the cheesecake, and now let's take a little bit of the sorbet. Oh my gosh. Wow. Sorbet. Mm-hmm. All right, I'm not going to eat all of your dessert. So I already know this is my sorbet.
Help yourself as much as you want.
Let's try the cherry. Cherry sorbet. Oh wow, that cold air feels good coming in here. All right, here we go. Oh my god. Wow. Yeah, that's a fruity sorbet. And then this is the orange. Although it looks, is it orange? Yeah, well, it looks, the color, it looks yellow like banana, but it's the orange. And the guy said, I'm going to taste it, but he said that the server said it tastes just like liquid orange, like frozen orange juice. So, oh my gosh, it does. All right. Well, let's eat our desserts before they melt. All righty. Well, that finishes up our meal at Alejo by Chef Jose Andre. I enjoyed it. It was good. You enjoyed it, right?
Yeah.
I will say this. I don't know that it's exactly my style of food or my kind of food. It's very good. Yeah, it's very different. It's definitely a great place, I think, to come. Maybe with like a group of a couple people where each person can kind of order like their little tapas and everybody can just kind of at the table share and experiment and try things. Because it was just the two of us, we only ordered those three items. And there's so much stuff on the menu, so many different tapas selections. I would like to actually like try more. So I think like for us to give it like our 100% honest review, we have to come back again. You know, maybe with like a group of people and try some more stuff on the menu. But I will say what we had was good, right? Yeah. I enjoyed it. I enjoyed the paella was very good.
I like dessert more.
I could almost see like if I was
come for dessert for some cup of coffee.
Yeah, I could almost see like if we're out at Disney Springs one night, like you know you want to kind of walk through this gorgeous walkway area that comes behind these restaurants, and then you could stop and maybe grab a table outside. Definitely, just as you're coming through here, you could just stop and maybe have like your dessert and coffee or something. But anyway, so the croquettes were good, the potatoes were great, the paella was awesome. Like I said, I don't know like if it's 100% my style. Maybe you guys out there have tried this type of food more or you're more familiar with it. But for what we had, I think we enjoyed it. And definitely want to come back and maybe with a bigger group of people and try a couple of more items on the menu. Do a little taste testing from each person's plate. So I would actually, yes. My recommendation then on this one is come to Jaleo's, check it out. If you have a bigger group, I think you'll even have a better experience. Everybody order something a little bit different. Everybody just kind of taste and eat off of each other. And I think you guys will have a great time. So I think that concludes this video then, right?
Right.
Yeah. Again, I want to thank all the new subscribers out there. And if you're new to the channel, now's a great time to hit that little subscribe button and hit the little bell notification icon as well. That way you can be notified every time we upload new videos. All right, guys. Take care. We'll talk to you next time. Bye.
Bye-bye.